Image galleries are important features for websites as they allow for the effective presentation of visual content, enabling businesses to showcase products, photographers to display their portfolios, and bloggers to illustrate their stories. Hover effects, such as animations or color changes, add an interactive element to image galleries and attract visitors to explore further, which improves overall engagement. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to create a sleek image gallery with a captivating hover effect. When you hover over an image, it will expand in width, while other images shrink at the same time, creating a visually engaging interaction. Before we begin, subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell if you haven't already to stay updated on our web development tutorials. Let's jump right in. We have set up a straightforward HTML page featuring a page title and a designated container for the image gallery. Each image will reside within its own div, marked with the class Gallery Panel. In addition, the foundational styles for the body and page title have already been established to ensure a minimal visual appeal. Before we move forward, let's integrate a few more stunning images from the talented contributors of Unsplash.com. Now let's return to our CSS file to style the image gallery and implement today's cool hover effect. To start, we set a maximum width and height for the container to maintain consistent sizing for the gallery. We then utilize margin inline to ensure center alignment along the horizontal axis. Additionally, applying justify content center along with a gap of 1 rem between images will maintain proper alignment while providing a breathing space. Now let's focus on styling the individual panels. We'll begin by temporarily adding a background color to map out their boundaries. This will help us visualize the layout more effectively. Following that, adding a border radius and setting the cursor property to pointer will enhance the visual appeal and indications. You may have noticed that some images appear wider than others. This is due to inconsistent aspect ratios these images have. To address this, we can add the flex property with a value of 1. This will ensure that the available space is equally divided among the panels, maintaining a consistent size regardless of individual image dimensions. Moving on to the images, let's assign them a width and height of 100% to make sure they fill the entire panel. However, you may notice that the images appear stretched. This can be fixed by applying the Object Fit property. Setting it to cover ensures that the images not only fill the entire space, but also maintain their original aspect ratios, resulting in a visually pleasing presentation. Now we can safely remove the background color. Even though we have applied a border radius, you may notice that the corners still appear sharp. The overflow property in this case can be set to hidden, ensuring that the images respect the boundaries of their panels, resulting in smoother, rounded corners. Next, it appears that the second and fifth images have slightly larger empty spaces at the top compared to the others. This has nothing to do with the code, it's just how these images are portrayed. While these issues could typically be resolved using a photo editor to crop out any unwanted space in the images, let's fix them directly in the CSS. In this case, we can achieve better alignment by targeting these specific images and scaling them up slightly using the nth child pseudo-class, which allows us to apply custom styling based on their position in the container. Now let's focus on implementing the hover effect. We will utilize the hover pseudo-class to reset the panel width when the mouse hovers over it. Specifically, it will increase the width of the hovered panel by 2.5 times its normal state. This will also trigger the other panels in the flexbox to shrink, freeing up space for the targeted image. The transition property can be used to smoothly animate the change in panel width during the hover effect, creating a polished transition between states. There's one last enhancement we can make using the has pseudo class. This recent addition to the CSS arsenal can allow us to change the appearance of siblings of an image while the image itself is being hovered over. It's a powerful tool that can add an extra layer of interactivity to our hover effect. This code checks if the gallery has at least one panel in the hover state, then selects all panels except the one being hovered over. Then the grayscale filter is applied to the sibling images, and the transition property is used to make the change smooth. By implementing creative hover effects like this, we can enhance our image galleries, making them more engaging for visitors while also improving website design and creating opportunities for user interaction and engagement. Feel free to experiment with the code by following the link provided in the description. Share your suggestions or feedback in the comments below, And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to stay updated on upcoming tutorials. Thanks for watching.